Well, hey, do you like puzzles? Or do you have students who finish their work quickly and you're looking for something challenging and engaging to go on with? Well, you've come to the right place. Watch on. Well, hi, my name's Tom Moore, and in this video, we're going to have a look at an activity which you'll find so engaging, you won't actually realize you're doing maths as you attempt it. And the activity is called Royal Arrangements, and how it works is like this. You can see I've got my aces, my jacks, my queens, and my kings all laid out in a 4x4 array. What you need to do is try and figure out a way to arrange these cards so that you only have one ace, one jack, one queen, and one king in each row, each column, and also each leading diagonal. That is this one here and this one here. By the way, leading diagonals mean the top left to the bottom right, and also the top right down to the bottom left. That's all it is in terms of diagonals. So let's go through and actually have a bit of a start at this. If I've got an ace here, well, if I move my ace here, then that can't work because I've got two aces in the leading diagonal there. So maybe I'll need to move my ace over here like that. Now, I'm gonna have to move this ace, aren't I? Because that's not gonna work here or this way. So I need to think about it. If I put my ace down here, that can work because I've only got one ace, well, I've got two aces, which I'll sort that one out in a second, but I've only got one ace, one ace, and one ace. So then if I move my ace, well, it can't go there because I've got an ace in this column. Can't go there because I've got an ace in this column, but it can go here because I don't have any aces in this column or row. So I can move that there like that. Now, if I have a look at it again, I've got an ace, a jack, a queen, a king. Fantastic, that's all right. An ace, a jack, a queen, a king. Excellent. Ace, jack, queen, king. King, ace, queen, king. Okay, well, that's definitely not going to work because I've got two kings there. And you can also see I've got more than one jack here and more than one queen here. Now, I'm not going to tell you any more on how to solve this problem. I think I've given you enough. Your challenge is to now go through and figure it out for yourself. So let me tell you a little secret. There's actually more than one solution to this problem. So what I recommend you do is once you find one solution, take a photo of it and then see how many other solutions you can find as well. And you could even have a competition with your friends to see who can find the most solutions in a week. Now, if you like this video, remember to subscribe so you get updates every time we post a new one. Also, comment and like below. Now, don't forget you can watch the teacher version of the video by clicking here, which goes through and explains how to take the problem further. My name's Tom Moore and best of luck.